Actually, one of the reasons I asked Hannah to play this is, since she's working on it, it's obviously not in quite final form yet, but it's not played that. This one is not played that much. You played it, right?
I'm playing it, but I don't remember the name.
Yeah, I know, it's not that often, not common. Have you played it?
Haven't
played it? Okay. Should be played, though. There's a lot in it, though. So what are some of the things that are in this say to? What are we kind of working on? What is the say to kind of do? There's a lot of different elements, but what are some of the obvious things?
The fourth finger and thumb position part at the end. A lot of
harmonics. Or even in the beginning, right?
Yeah, and in the beginning, too. Having a lot of notes per bow.
Okay, and that requires what technique for the bow?
The song filet.
Song filet. Everybody knows sans filet, no? What is sans filet?
It's when you're like playing a lot of notes in one
bow. Okay, and what does it mean actually?
Spun sound.
And it's basically figuring out very low contact point, very slow speed with lots of very light kind of left hand kind of playing. What else? So there's a couple of odd things.
Yeah, well, there's the weird 2-3
yeah.
Double stop thing that.
Yeah, and I don't even know. Do you know any literature that does that? I can't think of anything offhand. So I don't know what he was doing when he did that. You know why he was building that in. Show the spot that we.
Because
sometimes it kind of looked like she was just flattening her fingers out a little bit. I don't know if that
was
intentional.
Well,
no, I was just trying to do that to make it easier.
Okay.
Instead of going 1, 2, 2, 3, like scrunching it.
Yeah.
You can kind of push the arm across. That's one thing that you can do. But you can't really, it's not like a lot of things where you flatten it out. It doesn't work. Mm-hmm. Okay. Some other things?
All the harmonics that are like up here.
Okay, yeah. Well, there are other issues and other things that do that,
yeah.
Of course. Okay.
So
you
know
the last page thing that we talked about?
The last page.
We analyzed a little bit.
The changing keys?
Yeah. And you remember what we talked about with that?
Changing keys in thirds instead of fifths.
Right. And who's what harmony was that related to?
Based off of
Wagner. Okay. So one of the things that Popper in that period of time, you know, late 19th century, was bouncing off of what Wagner, who was the dominant composer of the German world, certainly, and pretty much everything he was doing was kind of, you know, challenging in lots of ways, harmonically as well as all kinds of other things, you know, instrumentation, so forth. And so one of the things he was doing is instead of building modulations based off fifths and fourths, he's building it off of thirds. And that's one of the things that this passage was doing, was building off of thirds. So instead of having just a limited number of keys you can go to, he's now going to many more possible kind of key things. And that's one of the things to look for when you're doing pop ranges. Can you do the bottom of the first page? Not that intonation was less than usual.
Where?
Like the second half of the first page or something where that spot starts. So that still, so you're hearing it.
Yeah, I don't know.
Yeah, I heard
it's
you
so
do that better.
Today.
What's that?
It's just so bad today.
I don't know why. Okay. Well, you know, again, you didn't warm up at all. You're just sitting in there. Did you play at all today?
I played for like 5 minutes.
Oh, yeah. Okay. Okay. So questions, comments, thoughts? If nobody's played, it's hard to. But maybe you remember something. Otherwise, some thoughts. That's going to take some slow work again on that spot. Also on the modulation spot on the last page, by the way. And I think you can hear it one more time in the last page.
Is that original tempo?
Yeah,
close.
It's a pretty good tempo.
Okay.
What's the another thing that he was doing there? What's the tonality in the beginning? What is he doing? Don't say. What is he doing in the beginning?
Is it like a pentatonic?
Exactly. Yeah. And he does that a lot. There's a lot because that was also in the air at the time. You know, they're starting to have connections. If you think late 19th century with Japan, right? And so the artists at the time, France and Paris, were you know being inspired by impressionists and so forth. Inspired. And he's not an impressionist, but he was also sort of inspired by those new harmonies and tonalities that were coming out of the pentatonic. Yeah.
To go along with it, there are definitely parts that I kind of felt like they were like kind of Debussy-ish.
Yeah,
like
probably because of that.
Like,
probably because of the pentatonic. This didn't have any octatonic in it. Did it? Okay, good.